So hi, I'm Michael, and today we're going to teach you a game called Order Order. Now to play this game, all you need is a deck of regular cards. Now we have gone from 0 to 10, so we have the queens being zeros in our deck, aces being 1, and we've taken out the jacks, kings and jokers. So the way the game works is you take out the 6 cards and you lay them out according to their, so we've got 6 of diamonds, 6 of clubs, 6 of hearts, 6 of spades. The aim of the game is to be the first person to get rid of all your cards. Now, Nash has laid these out because obviously the rest of the cards get dealt out between us. So we've got a giant hand of cards here. So we're kind of playing an open hand here where we can see each other's cards, which is fine. And the aim is to be the first person to get rid of all your cards. Now, on your turn, you can only place a card if it comes immediately before or immediately after a number in the sequence. So, Nash, you're okay if I go first?
Yeah, because
I'm still full count. I can't. Beautiful. Okay, so I'm going to play the 5 of spades first. And the 5 of spades I can play because it's immediately before, 5 comes immediately before 6, and the spades match. So I'm able to play that card. Nash, your turn.
All right. I'll
just
move them down.
So, Kay, just have a look at what you can place, and you can keep moving your cards around.
Seven of diamonds. Oh, wait, there's diamonds already. Oh, yeah, I
didn't. So, 7 of diamonds, and that would go there after the 6?
Yeah.
All right, beautiful. So, I'm going to
play. How do we know the winner?
First person to get rid of all their cards. I'm going to do 5 of hearts.
Five there.
5 of clubs.
Does anyone have 5?
I'm going to do 7 of spades.
I'll go 5 of diamonds.
5 of diamonds. Good. I'm going to go 4 of diamonds.
4 diamonds.
Okay. Oops. I'm going to go 4 of hearts.
Rocket, but only 15% of profits. Ever seen my pockets like 69 billion in the last 20 years spent on national defense, but folks still live in fear like nearly half of America's.
I've got 0 of diamonds. So once we've completed the row, we'll just check it's right, Nashi. Can you go through and check?
0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
And once we've got it right, we can pack that out.
Smash that.
And put it away. And that does a couple of things. One, it frees up some space on the table. But two, it removes the visual prompt for the other one. So now we're back to thinking what comes before, what comes after. So it's your turn, Nashi.
What are we talking about here?
So when you get towards the end of the game, it actually becomes quite strategic about what cards you place down when. So Nash and I are both down to 5. Nash has got 6 cards. All right, your turn, Nash.
8 of
clubs. I'll go 9 of clubs.
8 of spades.
I'm going to go 10 of clubs.
Hello, that one's smashed.
Your turn, Nash.
2 of that one.
Okay, and so I am going to put down the ace. I'm going to put ace of this one, ace of spades. And then I'm going to put, because at any time if you can't place a card, you miss a turn. I'll put ace there. Okay, so that means that's done. Do you want to check it, Nash?
0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay, now just sit back for a second before we wipe it out. You actually made a really good decision, Nash. So can you tell me why was it better to put that 0 down and then put that 9 down? So you put the 0 down.
You can't put the 10 down.
I can't put the 10 down, can I? Which means this is now finished. And it's my turn, and now I have to miss a turn. And then it's Nash's turn.
I win.
And that means Nash is our winner because I'm left with 1 card. So at the end of the game, lots of practicing of sequencing numbers, but at the end of the game, there's also a bit of strategy about what order you place them down in. That game's order. We hope you enjoy, and we will see you next time. Bye.